Hello students, today we are going to study a new poem, that is The Pulley. This is a metaphysical poem that uses the extended metaphor of a pulley to explain the reason for why man is always restless. In this poem, we are going to study the reason of man, why always he remains as restless, as well as the role of God in one's life. The Pulley poem, it is written by George Herbert. He was a Welsh poet. Welsh is a language. He was a priest by profession. He wrote religious poems with a lot of imagery and concepts. The poem exhibits a strange but two way of relationship between God and his worshippers. Though he has bestowed upon his worshipper with all his blessings, somewhere he holds them up with the pulley drawn to be grateful to him in all their endeavors. God gives so many precious gifts to the devotee, but at the same time, God also expects something in return. What does he expect? Why does he withhold? The pulley shows how God lifts man towards himself with the pulley of restlessness. What is distinctly metaphysical about the poem is that a religious notion is conveyed through a secular scientific image. In this poem, George Herbert, he brought the relationship between God and his worshippers, and God expects something from the worshippers. That we are going to study, how God holds them up with the pulley drawn. Pulley means a wheel. We have studied to drag out something, a wheel is used, but here the same pulley, it is put in a different way. So we are going to study this poem. Let me read the poem first, then I will explain. When God at first made man, having a glass of blessings standing by, let us pour on him all we can. Let the world's riches which dispersed lie contract into a span. So strength first made a way, then beauty flowed, then wisdom, honor, pleasure. When almost all was out, God made a stay, perceiving that alone of all his treasures, rest in the bottom lay. For if I should, said he, bestow this jewel also on my creature, he would adore my gifts instead of me and rest in nature, not the God of nature. So both should losers be. Yet let him keep the rest, but keep them with repining restlessness. Let him be rich and weary, then at last, if goodness lead him not, yet weariness may toss him to my breast. Before I explain the poem, let me tell you, I have already given the meanings on the next slide. You can refer it, but let me read it now. Riches means wealth, bounties, dispersed, scattered, contract, collect together, span, small space, perceiving, noticing, becoming conscious, bestow on, give as a gift to, jewel, a precious, valuable thing, adore, love very much. Repining restlessness, that means continuous anxiety due to dissatisfaction. Very, very tired. Toss, bring through close. Dear students, now we'll go to every verses. I'll explain the first verse of the poem. When God had first made a man having a glass of blessings standing by, let us pour on him all we can. Let the world's riches which dispersed lie contrast into a span. The poet says that the time when God first created a man, he had a glass of blessings standing by. He thought that he would be generous and shower on man all the gifts possible. God intended that all the treasures of the earth, which lay scattered, should be collected and concentrated in the small space he had created, which was man. So strength first made a way, then beauty flowed, then wisdom, honor, pleasure. When almost all was out, God made a stay, perceiving that alone of all his treasures, rest in the bottom lay. Let us go to the second stanza now. The first gift which was God gave for man was strength, the power. And then the power was followed by beauty, then wisdom, knowledge, honor, and happiness. When nearly all the gifts had been bestowed to him on man by the Almighty, suddenly God thought, why don't I stop for a while? And he stopped for a while. He noticed that, God has noticed, all the treasures, only one gift remained. Everything was poured, everything was blessed on man by God. Happiness, honor, precious thing, beauty, wisdom. But one thing was left, that was the rest. For if I should, said he, bestow this jewel also on my creature, he would adore my gift instead of me, and rest in nature, not the God of nature. So both should be losers. So God thought that, why don't I hold for some time? I give all the precious things to human being except rest. So God said to himself that if he bestowed this precious and valuable gifts to his creature or the creation, man would love and worship only the gifts of nature. Man love only the gifts which was gifted by the nature, which was gifted by the God. And human being will forget God. He will not remember God. So therefore, God thought that thus both God and man would finally lose each other. So people love the gifts which was gifted by nature, which was gifted by God. Therefore, God hold for some time before he bless everything. So one thing was left, that was the rest. The last line now. Yet let him keep the rest, but keep them with repining restlessness. Repining means continuous anxiety due to dissatisfaction. Let him be rich and weary. Let him be tired. Let him be rich. And that at last, if goodness lead him not, at weariness may toss him to my breast. So God, let him retain all other gifts, let him take all other gifts. But he left man restlessness. You know, my dear students, there are so many people in this world. They have everything, ample of money, ample of pleasure, whatever it is, they have lots of things to enjoy. They lead luxurious life, but still they are dissatisfied due to one or the another thing. Maybe the rich man, he struggles for the rest, peace of mind, whatever it is. In the same way, God let retain all the other gifts, but together with them he left man restless and continuously anxiety and dissatisfied. He thought that man should be rich with the abundance of gifts, but he should always remain tired and restless. Though the human being is blessed with abundant of gifts, but still he always remains tired and restlessness, my dear students. God reasoned that only then, at last, if the quality of goodness did not lead man back to God, suppose the person, until and unless the human being realizes that he should go to God, till that the God kept the person restless. So always here it is given, God expects something in return. When the person gets all sorts of luxury, he forgets Almighty, isn't it? Therefore, God uphold one thing, that is the rest, to take the person back to him, to pull the human being back to him. So this, the Puli poem says that it shows the relationship between God and human being. Though God has bestowed all the gifts to the human being, but one thing he upholds by not blessing one gift, that is rest, only to pull the man towards the God. So draw man back to God's heart. So this is a beautiful poem. It is written by George Herbert. It gives a complete picture of a relationship between human being and God. How God plays with human being. How God pulls back to his heart to the man, though the person is bestowed or blessed with all sorts of gift. My dear students, read the poem very carefully. Now I have already given the meanings, but for your reference, I have put the meanings in the video. You have to write all the given meanings in the notebook. Now this is the assignment, my dear students. You have to write an appreciation of the poem in a paragraph format. Earlier videos, you have experienced how to write an appreciation in the paragraph format. In the same way, you have to write it. Question number 2, solve all the necessary textual questions in your notebook. I hope you will follow all the instructions and do the needful. Thank you and have a nice day.